first time you have to ask yourself, you know, I've got a difficulty in the relationship. What could I do about it?
Yeah.
Rather than just going with the feeling. Maybe the feeling is joy and enthusiasm. Maybe the feeling is anger and frustration. But the moment you step back and you just go, is there anything that I can do vis-a-vis these emotions? And I think that's the beginning of a more conscious kind of vision of relationships. And I think that too often we don't see that there's anything we can consciously do to make our relationships go better. If they're starting to go wrong, we just think, oh well, that's just love has died, and love is just like this volcanic force within us. There's nothing we can do to make it grow or shrink or whatever. Or if suddenly sex has gone off the boil, we kind of just think, well, that's just how it is, you know, rather than actually desire. And the way desire works is it's got lots of kind of reasons behind it, and people will be become unable to have sex with one another if other things are not in place, or if there's maybe a kind of background of anger or bitterness, or, you know, so just becoming more psychological about relationships seems to be really key, but not spoken about as much as it should be, I think. Look, I mean, I think there's lots to be said for short-term relationships, short-termish relationships, and I don't want to say that only the long term is the real kind. But I think that for many people, at a certain point, they'll reach a point where they'll go, you know, I would really want a long-term relationship. I'm tired of having to explain myself again to another person. I'm tired of having to take a new person around my life, explain my family, my upbringing. I don't want to do that anymore. And I think that's a really interesting moment. You know, I'm looking forward to the age of the kind of psychological relationships where two people are not merely seeing a relationship as a hormonally driven thing or as a mysterious sort of like semi-divine force that's like visited you, but as something that you can kind of understand and with logical dynamics within it. And
negotiate a little.
Yeah, but also, you know, I mean, people are really interesting around sex, for example, because sex at one level seems so just a passionate force within you. But I think the reason why sex goes wrong often has got clear psychological reasons behind it, and that people are sometimes reluctant to explore. So, you know, I mentioned anger, but anger is a really key one. I think a really big feature of any relationship, if you're in a big city, say, is why am I with this person and not like somebody else, right? Because we're surrounded by choices all the time, and it's extremely tempting, and technology brings even more choices, etc. So in a way, one of the things we've got to kind of answer to ourselves is we've got to kind of come to a view of like, you know, why am I with this person rather than with another person? And frequently the thought is, it's an accident, it's a mistake, I've got the wrong model. And out there, there's this kind of better model that's less broken, that's less annoying, etc. Because we get to have such a kind of ringside seat on the floors of the person that we're with kind of long term. And, you know, by definition, we'll start to see strangers and think, well, surely they look quite nice, surely they would be easier. And I think it's a really important moment when we realize, without wishing to kind of do down the charms of strangers, that anyone is going to be carrying a lot of complexity within them. It might be a different kind to the one that your partner's got, but there just will be a lot of stuff. And it's so hard to trust that that's actually true.
They're always so pretty, aren't they?
Exactly, exactly. That's the thing. And you just can't believe it. And they're so charming because people are genuinely charming. But the thing is, your partner's charming too. You've just forgotten to look at them in that way. And because you own them, like everything we've ever owned ever since we were children, we don't really like it. We like the other guys and toys.
It's a bit boring.
So I think, so I don't want to say that like all relationships should stick together, but I think some relationships end prematurely, and a lot of hurt is caused by actually interpretations of, you know, what love should be that are misleading and unnecessary destruction.